Hey, this is Nate Story with Riot Agritech, and today as part of our nutrient series, I'm going to talk quickly about sulfur. So we have the primary plant nutrients, and everyone's seeing this as MPK. But then our secondary macronutrients are calcium, magnesium, and sulfur. We've already talked about calcium, we've chatted about magnesium pretty quickly, and today I'm going to quickly address sulfur because a lot of people are concerned about it. So sulfur is present in our system in the form of sulfate, or SO4, okay? Sulfate is just floating around our system and the plants are taking it up and they're reducing it and they're using it for mostly things like building amino acids and other chemicals that are very important to the plant. So this is how sulfur occurs in the system. Now you'll also notice that a lot of the amendments that we've talked about over the years are sulfate-based amendments, okay? So potassium sulfate, in the last video we talked about Epsom salts, magnesium sulfate, and I've heard it from a lot of different people. I say, oh well, use a potassium sulfate to help supplement potassium. And they say, okay, that's great, but I'm really, really worried about having too much sulfate in my system. So today I'm gonna talk a little bit about that and sulfur toxicity, sulfate toxicity. We're just gonna kind of debunk the idea that sulfate is a problem in most aquaponic systems. So sulfate is almost never deficient. I have yet to see an aquaponic system where there was a problem with sulfate being too low. I've also never seen a system where there's a problem with sulfate being too high. Now, I will say that in aquaponic systems, sulfates tend to run pretty high. Some folks have systems that run up above 100 parts per million, some even 180, 200 parts per million. That's not necessarily a problem. I will say, try to keep your sulfate below 60 parts per million, ideally. But if it bumps even way up above that, you're not gonna be hurting your plants and you're probably not gonna be hurting your fish. Now, the worst thing that can happen is you'll start to see a little bit of a nitrogen deficiency, because what happens is this sulfate starts to interfere with nitrate uptake in the plants. So long before you actually see any kind of toxicity, you're just gonna see a reduction in your nitrate use. And the way you recognize that is a nitrogen deficiency, but when you test your water, you've got high nitrates consistently. So that's one way to diagnose the fact that you've got a little bit too much sulfate in your system. Now, is this something to be worried about? Probably not. Like I said, I've seen very few systems where sulfate is a problem, either too much of it or too little of it. Remember that plants can take up variable amounts of these compounds. So if you've got a little bit too much of something, oftentimes the plants are just taking up extra. That's called luxury consumption. It's more than they need, but you know, it's not gonna hurt them. It's not always gonna help them, but it's certainly not gonna hurt them. So that's important to remember. When you're adding sulfate-based supplements, so potassium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, that kind of thing, most likely you're not gonna have to be worrying about having too much sulfate in your system, any kind of toxicity. So feel free to add away until you start to see a loss of efficiency when it comes to nitrate uptake. Again, this is a really important plant nutrient. So sulfur, plants use almost as much of it as phosphate at different times. So this is definitely something you need in your system, and you will probably be supplementing it in some form or another. So if you have been worried about sulfate, if you are using sulfate-based supplements, stop your worrying, keep an eye on your nitrate consumption, and enjoy being able to supplement really potent forms of certain elements in combination with sulfate, and just enjoy the fact that you can have a really healthy system in a hurry using sulfate-based supplements. Hey, hopefully this video is really useful to you, definitely check out the Vertical Food blog after this video posts. We'll definitely do a blog post on sulfate, on sulfur, why plants need it, how much is too much, how much is too little. We'll go through some more of the details on the blog, and so check that out. Also, check out the store if you're interested in towers. We've got a lot of new kind of products coming out here in the next couple months, so keep an eye on that. Thanks so much for watching. If you find these videos useful, do subscribe. Hey, this is Nate Story with Bright Agritech. Today we're going to talk a little bit about magnesium as part of our ongoing series on managing your nutrients in your aquaponics system. We're adding potassium to the system, and many folks who are adding like seaweed extracts, that kind of thing, they don't realize that they're also supplementing potassium.